Hello, my name is Bo Huang. I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Pharmaceutical Chemistry at UCSF. I came from China. I got my bachelor's degree of chemistry from Peking University in China. Then I went on to get a PhD in chemistry at Stanford University. Before I chose to join UCSF faculty, I did my postdoc at Harvard University. So the research in my lab is to find ways so that I can directly observe how a molecule functions in the cell, especially in the living cell. We do this mostly through using light as a tool. And in particular, a number of groups, including us, has developed a method called super-resolution microscopy. What it does is allow a microscope to see things almost the size of a protein molecule. This has been deemed as impossible because it's simply against the physical principles, because the wavelength of light is about two orders of magnitude larger than the size of a protein molecule. Super-resolution microscopy circumvented this limit. And the method that we are particularly using is called stochastic optical reconstruction microscopy, or STORM, utilizes some specific photophysical property of molecules that can emit light. In this way, we can find out the exact position of every molecule one by one. And using those positions, we can figure out the structure. So why we care about this high resolution? Well, it's exactly because cells are not just a bag of enzymes. It's really a precisely organized machine. For example, there are many molecular complexes, many protein or nucleic acid molecules come together to perform a coherent function, such as those involved in DNA duplication in protein synthesis. The signaling in the cell is also spatially regulated. There are small compartments, small domains to confine all these signals from spreading out to everywhere inside the cell. Those structures are often too small to study by conventional light microscopy and too big to study by existing structural biology method. And this molecule to cell length scale gap is exactly what we want to bridge. By doing this, we will be able to get really deep understandings of how cell functions all the way from cellular level down to the molecular level. In the same way, we will be able to figure out the mechanisms of how a disease develops as well as how we can cure it.